So after mixed doubles, we return to men's singles, and Kashyap Parupalli of India is up against number 7 seed Tien Minh Nguyen from Vietnam.
All tails? One, two,
so
head.
This second round encounter in the men's singles. Both of these men having already played one match. Defeated Zilberman as well in two straight games. This man, Kashyap Parupalli, had a much tougher encounter against Dunkup of Germany. Needed three games to overcome him. 21-11 in the deciding game. So the 24-year-old, though he's going to turn 25 on the 8th of September, Kashyap, born in Bombay, 28 in the world rankings at the moment, and just a positive win-loss record for this year, playing in his third World Championships. Previous 2 years when he's played, one first round loss, another second round loss. That was when the event was staged in Hyderabad in India. Lost out to the number 2 seed Chen Jin, who went on to reach the final. And then a year later, of course, last year in Paris, Chen Jin won the gold medal. But in those World Championships in Hyderabad, this man actually took him the full distance, three games. Very good performance it was too. But since then, he's won a bronze medal at the Commonwealth Games. But he's up against it today because he's up against the number 7 seed, world ranking of 7. And a healthy win-loss record for the year. Reached the final of the US Grand Prix event. Lost out to Sho Sasaki in that final. But in the quarterfinal, had beaten Bao Chun Lai, one of the top Chinese players, and also defeated Mark Zwiebler on his way through to that final. So he's had a good year. As Tien Minh Nguyen of Vietnam, the 28-year-old, born in Ho Chi Minh City. Second consecutive World Championships where he's been seeded 7, making his 4th appearance at World Championships. In fact, for the last 2 years, has reached the last 16. Back in 2009, lost out to Lee Chong Wei, the number 1 seed. The number 1 seed here again this year, the Malaysian Lee Chong Wei. Lost out last year to Park Sung Hyun. Went on to take a bronze medal. So our court officials. There we are, Ivo Kassel.
Ladies from and gentlemen,
and
on my right,
Lawrence Bester of South Africa.
Vietnam. And on my left, P. Kashyap, India. P. Kashyap to serve. Love all. Play.
So the 24-year-old Indian, Kashyap Parupalli. Nearest to us getting his second round encounter underway. And Morton, despite the fact that he's lower ranked of these two players, 28 in the world as opposed to 7, this is the 4th meeting between these two players. The previous three, Kashyap has won 2 of them.
Yes, doesn't surprise me. You know, looking at it, none of the two players are having what I call a killer weapon. They are pretty much runners, both of them, and I would be very surprised if... okay, quick match. Point taken. But, you know, I think as the game develops, we will see long rallies. They are running players, both of them, and it doesn't surprise me that Kashyap can win.
Yes, it has to be said, the last time they met, which was in the last 32 of the US Open, Tien Minh Nguyen won on that occasion. And I suppose the last time that two players meet has more of an influence on the psychology, even if you've got a worse record against your opponent.
As long as you know it can be done, and especially if you have the last one in the back, then it means a lot.
A good start here from Tien Min. That's a nice shot.
Service over.
You talk about their running capabilities, Morten, but... You know, I'm looking down the list of results from Tien Min, and, you know, going back to 2007, had a victory over Taufik Hidayat, former World and Olympic champion. 2009, last 16 of Singapore, beat the world number one, Lee Chong Wei. Three games against Lin Dan as well. He does have the occasional good result, but he is a very physical player. And the thing that bothers me about Tien Min is that because he's so physical, to beat one of the top players, to win a tournament like this, he's got to beat three or four of them.
Three at least.
Yeah, exactly. So whether he has the physical capability, because of his style of play, to go all the way through is perhaps a question mark in my own mind.
I couldn't agree with you more. His advantage is that he's so quick on his legs. He's really, really quick. But I think he's using it too defensively.
Yeah.
He's not looking enough for opportunity. I'm not saying that he can't play winners, as we saw suddenly a very good straight smash from the backhand side. Why don't we see that more? You know, I want him to look more for opportunity and really try to score the points, because he's got such a solid defense, and then he's missing a defensive shot. So I'm really doing well here. But he is, and that's the reason why he's having these odd, really, really good results. It's the fact that, you know, he can run, he can stay with them, he's really fast, and he's got such a solid defense. And is good around all the flat play and play to the body and all that. So he can really stay with his opponent if he wants.
Long, hard-fought rally, as you suggested we might see.
Neither one of them can get it down. This rally, Kashyap have already given up doing any sorts of explosions. He's just playing it back. It's too far. You can see he thought it was pointless trying to do any explosions, trying to finish the rally. So he was sort of giving up on that because it was too long already.
Bronze medalist at the Commonwealth Games last year. Kashyap. But just to emphasize the point that we've been talking about with Tien Min Nguyen, he's never actually reached a final of a Super Series event, despite the fact that he's won nine titles throughout his career, never even a final of a Super Series where you have to beat the top players back to back.
He's got to work too hard to get there.
Very much a courtesy amongst the players to just try out the new racket.
5-3. Play.
That's a good return of serve. Now, we've talked about Tien Min. What about this man, Kashyap? What's his qualities?
I think that Kashyap has worked up his way in the ranking pretty well over the last few years, and he's a steady player. He again is a counter-attacking player, as what we just saw now. But again, I'm looking for either he's got to play slightly sharper shots, or he's got to find that killer shot somehow. He again has got to work too hard to win his matches, to really make a huge impact on tournaments. Oh, that's beauty. That's the beauty.
Service over. Seven.
But very skillful and a very hard worker, and a lovely player to watch, I think.
Like so many of the Indian players, yes. Going back to your day with Prakash. Yeah,
absolutely, they play magnificent badminton.
Gopi Chand, who's yeah. here as the head coach. Yeah.
Serve is over. 6-7.
Syed Modi.
Syed Modi. Yeah. Tragically murdered.
Yes.
As he left training session. Commonwealth Games gold medalist in 82. Very sad. Spinella Gopi Chand.
See, that's, I think he's complaining a bit, and I can understand him, because Kashyap played a lovely attacking clear down to the forehand side, and Chen Min was really caught. But he was not really doing anything. He was even caught by surprise that the fact that the drop shot was coming. It should have been a clear winner. Now, luckily for Kashyap, it did not go over and all that. But he was caught by surprise. Try to look at this. That one completely caught, and then he's getting caught by that shot there. You know, when you're in a situation where you put so much pressure into that deep forehand corner, you know, chances are there's something coming to the front of the court, and he's getting completely surprised.
So when, as a player, you see your opponent turn, in other words, they're going to have to take the shuttle late, yeah. you should be looking
you
for the net.
You have to seek in straight away. You have to look for the attack.
I certainly remember you doing that, Morton.
You have to do it like instinct.
Yeah.
Serve is over. 8-7. Yes.
See, that's much more like
nine,
it.
Seven.
Really, really good smash. Solid. The explosion there is so good, how he gets up there, and that steep angle. Good shot.
You know who he reminds me of, Tien Minh? A Lee Chong Wei 7 or 8 years ago as a runner. But Lee Chong Wei has developed his game. He's got a new dimension. He's got explosive power, explosive movement now.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
Broken string in the racket of Kashyap. But I was just watching that rally, Morton, and exactly the same thing again. Kashyap played a wonderful tight spinning net shot.
Yes.
He got a high lift. Okay, it was a good lift,
yeah.
but he didn't even jump towards the shuttle to play an angle. He played what you describe as a soft shot,
yeah.
drop straight back to the middle.
Yeah.
Didn't put pressure on, having played a very good shot, then didn't follow it up.
Exactly, and it's, as I say, that kind of shots in my book qualifies as what I've said before in the no shot category, because it's not a shot, it doesn't work, it may have no effect.
So level once again.
That's another
nice.
One. That's good.
Service over.
That's another one.
10-9. Yes.
Another broken string. It'll be an expensive match.
What do you think is the problem? Is he mistiming the shot, or is he has he strung the rackets too tightly? Him personally, but
No. I think a bit of both.
Yeah.
The tension in the strings is enormous these days, and again it's a little beyond my understanding that they need to be so tightly strung that you slightly miss hit and the string is gone.
Yeah,
I think you lose a lot of points on it. It's in. Yeah.
Service over. 10-0.
That's nice to see. Really, really good play.
So the number 7 seed, T.M.Nguyen from Vietnam. With the narrowest of possible margins at the mid-game interval. 261. First half of this opening game. Well, coming back to the strings on the rackets, I gather nowadays that they're strung about 30 pounds, some of the players have. Now, this is going to date me, but I think I had mine strung between 22 and 24. But,
yes.
the point is, apart from the progression in technology and the strings are now they're developing a string that is used of a material that's in bulletproof vests
even thinner
with remarkable strength, but the more the tension, surely the shorter time the racket will spend on the strings, it will
less
pop
control.
Off less control, that's my point,
less control.
And I think everybody's obsessed with maybe the power of the smash, but it's the placement, it's the tactical nous, and in fact probably the variation in pace that's so important in badminton.
It is, and I think especially when it comes to singles, if you can in most cases hit as hard as you want, yes you would play a few winners now and again, I accept it, but it's the control, it's your ability to make use of the full court that makes the difference between the players.
Yeah. This is a very good rally, isn't it?
It is.
Oh, got caught, managed to get out of trouble.
That's going
wide.
Yeah.
Well, a very odd looking shot there from Tien Min. Was going to play the round the head, realized he couldn't do that. Played the backhand, got beautiful control off it. There he goes.
Yeah. Got away with it. Again, that's where I think the instinct or the reading of the game of Kashyap is lacking a little bit. He have to pick up that instantly, that there's trouble in the defense on the other side, and you have to move in. Yeah, that's bad luck.
13-10.
That's really good aggression on the return of serve. I like that. Really good. Coming in there, it's a bit unlucky. Idea was fine, I think.
Four straight points here. Number 7 seed.
Lucky point.
Yeah, very lucky.
Service over. 11-40.
Thank you.
That's a good shot, that one, but that one is obviously a poor shot. There's too much panic. He wants to win it too quickly, I think. Trying to counter-attack a situation that's quite difficult. That's nice.
Yeah,
very
that's
good angle. Very good angle indeed. Beautiful play.
13-14.
That's nice. Very nice. But that's, you know, it's actually striking me. I have to admit, I haven't followed Chen Ming that much. I haven't seen that many matches. But now when I'm, you know, watching it, like what we are watching it now,
we
are on it. It surprises me that I considered him
15,
as a very strong defensive
30.
Player. And I still think, obviously, he is. But his defense is not that constructive.
No.
I don't know if I explain myself correctly here. But it's like...
Fault receiver.
Oh, fault receiver.
16,
moving before the serve was struck.
13.
But it's like when he's playing the defense, it's not so sharp.
It's very good spot by the umpire. So what would you like to see him doing more? When he is defending, try and turn the shuttle more? Or
play more angles and play sharper shots. He's
14,
kind of just blocking 16. Them, not really doing much about it. If you notice when he's catching Kashyap in the deep forehand corner, Kashyap plays flat down the line, he just blocks it.
Mm.
If the attack is coming, you don't see where he's moving his opponent with the cross-court drop shots and playing sharp shots like that, or, you know, he's just merely blocking them. I'll try to see if I can find some examples as we go along. See, that's a fine example, that one. I know it wasn't going over.
15,
had it gone over, what would
16.
Have happened?
It was back to the middle.
It was straight back in the middle.
Yeah. So on this instance, what should he have tried to do instead of just blocking back to the middle?
The cross court to the forehand, short forehand, over there, yes.
Yeah, towards Kashyap's forehand side, yeah, I can see that. So back level, 3-point deficit has been closed. A slight difference of opinion between the two players as to whether the shuttle should be changed or not, and therefore Ivo Kassel having to make the decision for the players. He decides that the shuttle's fine.
Retrieving, but the smash coming to his backhand corner again, he only managed to
16.
Block it, and the block is very loose and he's losing it from there,
and therefore Kashyap able to play that cross court,
that one, and then it's just setting it up as a chess game, and then that's coming.
Yeah, well, this the first time in this opening game that Kashyap has been in the lead.
As long as you get there on 21, that's fine.
Yeah, it's not how you start, it's how you finish.
Yes.
Kashyap. Thank you.
good defense. Well played back of the net there by Chen Min. Very nice. Yeah.
Service over, 17-all.
You could just sense how the players were feeling that was an important rally. Both of them very, very
18,
eager in
18,
that.
18, 16, 17-all.
Yeah. Psychologically, there's a big difference, isn't there? I have to say, when this man has got through to finals of tournaments, he's got a very, very good record. 9 titles from 10 finals reached, 90% success rate in finals, and that's pretty impressive. But as I say, none of them the top tier of tournaments, all of them Grand Prix or international events, second or third tier. Ever done it. It's wide.
Service over. 18-17.
There was an attempt, cross-court attempt there by Chen Ming. That was good. That's excellent. That's excellent.
Well, I think it's fair to say this game has developed in an unexpected way. Now, especially this man, prepared to be the aggressor, prepared to take the initiative, hit the smashes.
Goodbye, Kashyap. He's really standing his grounds in this rally, I think. He's slightly under pressure most of the time, but playing good solid shots. And that's a nice defense there. And that's creating a chance, so at least a chance for a mistake.
So just 2 points away from this opening game. Kashyap.
Really, really good play from both sides.
Oh, it's just long. A little look from Kashyap, looking up towards the giant screen to see if the replay is coming.
It's coming soon. But I think his line service judge is right. It's out. I quite think it's out. Let's see. Yes, definitely.
Thank you.
must say, I think it's fantastic badminton they play. It's good pace, really safe, steady play, but still they're going for a lot of shots.
Well, I'm really surprised that the umpire has allowed Kashyap to go off and have a towel down. It's game point after all. Yes, it was a hard physical rally.
Continuous game.
Yeah, it's interesting that Tien Minh has stayed on court. And he's sending a message not only to his opponent, but also to the umpire. Saved on game point. The slice he put on that.
That was a very good slice. You could hear it on the sounds. He was striking the shuttle.
So game point saved. And it's 20 all. Extra points required. Oof, that's equally as good.
Yeah.
21-20.
Second game point opportunity for Kashyap.
Service over. 21 all.
Seemed to get all tangled up in his defense there. Wasn't quite sure whether to.
No, forehand, backhand.
Yeah.
It's coming here. If we can see it. That's when he's quick.
Yeah.
Quick getting across the court there. Been attacked on the backhand side and slightly off balanced, and still he's attacking on the forehand side there. Very quick across the court.
Yes, and he had taken a step forward as well, followed forward, which is what you've been saying that you really have to do. Well, no, he's already hit one at 261. But that one was more important because it's brought him game point.
Shot.
Oh, phenomenal.
It's on the line.
That was brilliant. Yes, certainly was on the line. Marvellous. What courage.
Yeah. Both agreed on that. That's painful. 22 all and then serving out.
Second game point opportunity now for Tien Minh.
And that took courage as well, attacking that short serve, low serve, as it's been faulted once before, moving too early. Out.
Missed it.
That's out.
This time. Second time of asking, and T.M.Nguyen of Vietnam, the number 7 seed, eventually secures the opening game. 24-22, having saved two game points, and then converts himself, and he will be very relieved about that. 31 minutes for that 24-22.
Yeah, 31 minutes, it says a lot. It's a tough match.
Yeah.
Imagine you have to go all the distance in three sets. We're talking about an hour and a half.
rồi mới lưu dạng nhớ chứ đánh đừng có tự trách mình ai đánh tình đến mình để lỡ bỏ những cái khác.
No, I saw the play just out of the corner of my eyes and out on court number four, I think.
Yeah, because that was a very physical match as well, 55 minutes that. Now, why would a player change shoes in the middle of a match?
You must find them uncomfortable.
Okay. It's not so full of perspiration that
no,
getting slippery.
No, not here. It's only when we used to play in the Far East.
With no air conditioning.
Yes. That, it was essential to do it.
Yeah.
Between sets.
Ball one, 20 seconds. Ball one, 20
But that's the funny thing. Yeah, I think most players have it. I'm sure you had it, I had it, everybody have it. That, you know, when you're traveling, there's two things you always bring in into your hand luggage. Your rackets and your shoes.
Yeah.
Those two, so important.
Goodness, the number seven seed had to work so hard in that opening game.
Love
all. 24-22 is margin of victory. 31 minutes. That's good judgment.
Service over. One love.
Of course, we know that already there is one Indian player through to the third round. DJ Jayaram, disposed of Ivanov of Russia earlier today.
Yeah, that was a comfortable win. Scores indicated a little different, but I think he was quite a lot in control.
I know, Morten, you were talking during the mixed doubles, the last match, that we saw about the resurgence of Japan in badminton terms.
Yes.
But I think there's a real resurgence of Indian badminton as well.
Yes.
And it's not just one or two players, there's a whole squad of players.
They have a lot of players coming up, yes.
So Jay Jayaram against Vladimir Ivanov, 21-19, 21-17, 34 minutes.
Yeah, but he was in control.
Yeah, and 34 minutes says that.
Yeah.
31 minutes for our opening game.
Exactly.
3-1.
So now it's really important for Kashyap to stay with Tien Minh in the beginning of this set. Now he must not run away. That was a good defense from Tien Minh, and he's capitalizing on it. That's what I mean, you know, that's a lot more constructive defensive play here, creating the opportunity for the counter-attack.
This is dangerous times, is it not?
Yeah.
5-1 advantage, a game up. Dangerous for Kashyap. Has to somehow find a way.
Gotta watch out, the train is going now. It's got to get on board. Oh, that's beautiful. Really nice. Good deception.
Service over. 2-6. Service over. 7-2.
Yeah, he's urging himself on. He knows the importance of keeping within touching distance.
Service over.
That won't help his cause.
8-3. Yes.
Just out.
Oh, goodness me, what happened there?
Turn it over. 4-8.
Obviously haven't done counts on it. You have to do that watching it in replay for the whole match. But every time Chen Min is going in and playing this flat, where he's attacking there, he's not really scoring anything. He doesn't get anything out of it, and most of the times he's actually losing the rallies. Which is something he had to register somewhere. Say, okay, is this worthwhile doing it for me? Do I have to do other stuff than this?
Fight back by Kashyap. But how much of that, Morton, is down to the individual player, and how much nowadays down to the coach? I know in the good old days when you and I were playing that it was very much more up to the individual to recognize their weaknesses, work things out. Whole army of coaches involved nowadays helping the players.
They can talk constantly. As soon as shuffle out again, out of play, obviously they can talk. They can talk between rallies as well. So obviously it's a job for the coach straight away to go in and say, listen, this is probably not a good idea. I still remember a long time ago I was coaching Peter Gade in a tournament in Malaysia, and we were playing someone from Korea. And I said, we don't know anything about this Korean player. But no, so one thing we know about Korean players in general is that they're very good in flat, you know, flat exchanges. So don't do that. The Peter said, no, I'm better than him. He was 11-1 down, just trying to play flat. I said, listen, don't do it. Don't do it.
Service over. 10-7.
Again, a good return. It's amazing how often he's losing on that one, when you consider how quick he is on his legs. Oh, that's poor. He's lucky. And again, I have to say, when I think it's a poor shot, you have to take into consideration we are talking about number 7 in the world here.
Yeah. So the advantage, 3-point advantage at mid-game interval. Yeah, it's always a sign that a player is confident and feels good when the coach, she's gone back to her.
It's very important that the coach is precise, pointing out very few things and be very precise. You can maybe explain it in one or two or three different ways, but you be very specific about what you're talking about.
11-8. Play.
Clearly in. That's a bad misjudgment from Kashyap.
Have Chen Min played any shots down the line from his short forehand corner?
Service over.
Answers
nine.
No. It goes cross court every single time. No, I know this one before was the winner, but every single time he's got it in his short forehand, he's crossing it.
Nicely done. Oh, it's just long.
Service over. 13-10.
Short.
Just put it into the middle.
Service over. 11-13. Yes.
That was good. Last shot here, that one to the backhand there. Clever play.
Surprised that when he was off balance, deep in his backhand corner, that he chose to clear cross court. Because there is a huge gap down the forehand side if you're
there
off balance. If you've got in position nicely, so by the time you're landing with your round the head shot, you're coming back towards the base position, then that's fine. You can cover that, but
otherwise you have to hit it with very good proper height and length.
That he's got this opportunity to catch back up and and then a couple of times when he's getting desperately close, he's made an error.
Exactly, yeah, that's exactly the same feeling I'm sitting with here watching it.
I'd love to see a third game, I have to say. It's a fascinating
encounter. Very good game, very good game. Cross, oh, okay, he's got it so late.
Well played.
Service over. 13-15.
That's goodbye, Kashyap.
Kept alert, didn't he? Didn't panic.
No. and he played the shot before that tight enough, so he couldn't really kill it. So that was good. So now we have the situation. 14-15, Kashyap is catching up. So desperately close. Will he make a mistake or two now and then be 17-14 down?
Service over.
You can't really call that a mistake.
No.
So in all honesty.
Yeah, look at the speed with which T.M.Nguyen goes back to hit this smash.
That's it. Enormous speed. Starts.
Serve is over. 15-16.
So another opportunity to get back level. Going out.
Oh, that's good. That's really, really good.
16-all.
Indeed, he is back level, and what a rally. Indecision there. I was convinced it would have gone out. But that final smash, that jump round the head, as we call it, plays still with the normal overhead action. Because his whole body weight was falling out of court. It's awfully easy with that smash straight down the line to drag it wide of the singles court. But he managed to control it.
Yeah, it was excellent.
Well, it's a miss hit, but they all count. And indeed, into the lead.
Wasn't he in the lead at this time in the first set as well?
Yep, he went from 13-16 down to 17-16 up.
Yeah, just like now.
Yep.
Serve is over. 17-all.
Deja vu. He's applying good pressure from the front of the court, is Kashyap Parupalli. And again. 2 points away from this second game. 3 game points, 3 opportunities to send it to a third and deciding game. Thank you.
Oh, he's done it. Extraordinary comeback. What courage, what fighting spirit from Kashyap Parubali. Takes the second game, 21-17. Well, remarkable, because from 14-16 down, promptly won 7 of the next 8 points to close it out, 21-17. 51 minutes. Well, I have to be honest, I thought he was down and out at one stage. 4 points adrift at 8-12. But he started being much, much more positive from the front of the court, applying pressure. Stepping in, taking it a little earlier. Change of shirt for both men. Oh, no. Gopi Chand has obviously said something. I don't know exactly what he said, but something about the forehand at the net. He was talking about taking it early, playing a tight spinning net shot, or turning across court, or pushing. If I'm interpreting the hand gestures correctly. Now that is precisely what Morten Frost was saying he needed to do, because applying angles, applying pressure from the front of the court, absolutely vital. So one game all. Third and final game. No, that's wide. The drift, as we look down on the court, is going from right to left. And this is why this one drifted out. Just wide of the singles court there. Yeah, good aggression.
Serve is over. 1-1.
Fascinating at the start of the match, because both Morten and I were talking about the fact that both of these players, very steady, very good athletes, run an awful lot, keep the shuttle going. But as the match has developed, second half of the first game, the second game, and now start of the third game, we're seeing some very aggressive, positive play. Almost contorted the back there, Tien Minh, played around the head smash. And it is all very different to the opening of the match now, Morten, isn't it? Much more positive and aggressive, both players.
Absolutely, they sense they have a chance of winning and they're really going for it. Follow-up. That's what we looked at in the first set when we were discussing it, you know, how to follow up, how to make sure you can finish the rallies, and I think Kashyap is doing really well here.
So back level. India have certainly had a quarterfinalist in the women's singles. They've had quarterfinalists in world championships in mixed doubles. Have they ever had a quarterfinalist? 77? What was Prakash?
Oh, in 1980 he was quarterfinal in Jakarta.
I thought they'd had a quarterfinalist before, yeah. Of course, in the men's singles, history will be made here at these World Championships because either Guatemala or Spain will have their first ever quarter-finalist
in
men's singles.
Yeah.
Great to see new countries emerging. And should, of course, Tien Minh get through to quarter-final stage, he'd be the first ever player from Vietnam to be in a World Championship quarter-final.
Yeah. That's really good for the game that is spreading out and showing such quality everywhere.
Now this is a very, very good run of points. Five straight points from 1-3 down to 6-3 up. Seven straight points now. But we shouldn't forget that in the second game, Kashyap was 3-8 down, came back to win it. So let's not count Tien Minh out yet. Missed it.
Yeah.
Turn is over. 4-8.
So as the match time just ticks over the hour mark. Didn't miss by much, did he? Still top quality badminton.
Very fit players, both of them, they're very fit. Maintain high standard, high pace all the way. Out.
I was going to ask you, though, obviously with Kashyap having a 55-minute match in his first round, it's that as this match progresses now past the hour mark, could that have an effect or not really?
Not really. He should be fit enough and his style of play suggests to me that he is definitely fit enough. He's played like that all his life and I'm sure he's used to it.
Yes, and producing a quality smash like that.
And very well disguised. If we see it from the back, there, I don't know if you could see the disguise. Everybody would thought he was going cross court.
Yeah. And for Vietnam fans, worrying body language from Tien Minh at the end of that rally, showing his bitter disappointment.
And his shot there.
Thank you.
can't ever accuse either of these players for lack of effort, can you?
Definitely not. But again, surprisingly, I think that they are allowed to have a break when you, you know, you fair chance of one more point and the break at 11.
That round the head smash, doesn't he?
Yes.
T.M.Nguyen. Cross court. How many times have we seen that? It's a super angle from Kashyap Parupali.
Again, a lot of winners have come from exactly that one in this match.
Kashyap in that last rally, really making T.M.Nguyen move the full diagonal of the court, made him move that twice. I'm not quite sure what Gopichan was saying that.
No, I don't think it was in English.
First signs of tiredness to me. Kashyap's movement back in court there.
Yeah.
And also the air up with his overhead. Look, there's no real spring in the legs.
Instant lift off. Shot, but he got it so early. That's the main thing. It's getting up there early. Yeah.
Yes, in between the second and third game, I surmised that Gopichan was actually saying to him, he was talking specifically about the forehand net shot, sometimes taking it early, sometimes playing it cross court, but the emphasis appeared to be on take it early.
Eight.
That was a superb net shot from T.M.Nguyen.
That
was incredible, wasn't it?
Jumping forwards, just trying his luck.
Well, have we got a comeback here from Yun?
10-30.
To try to go for that one.
Yeah.
No, he's playing risky business at the moment.
Cushion once again. Pushed it wide.
Service over. 11-15.
Yeah, the quality has dropped a bit here, but that's only very natural. The players are getting a little bit tired now, I think.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. 70 minutes of play.
12-15.
An intensive play at that.
Yes, anything can happen still. It's 15-10 now, it's 12-15.
Oh, string's gone again.
Yeah. How many times can you afford it?
15.
Yeah, because that's... Is that four gifted points now with four rackets gone?
Four rackets, but he actually won one of them.
He knew immediately, didn't he?
Yeah.
Can tell by the sound. Shuttle coming off the strings makes a very different sound.
Pling.
Didn't know you were an impressionist.
No, I'm not.
Good lift. Damage had been done. Court will need to be mopped. Oh, for perspiration, remarkable defence there.
Thank you. 16-13.
This was the indecision. Suddenly decides to play it. From the return of serve.
Yes, once again. I think he's bold on that one, especially when you consider that he's been faulted once.
Yeah.
You know, it's a bold move going in and really going fast on these returns.
Oh,
I know it's easy for me to say now. In the beginning, I felt that Chen Min, could win it, wrap it up quite easily, but he couldn't. But in the third set here, I think Kashyap has played far better. Yeah. The quality of his shots, his shot selection, everything he's done is far better. He deserves to win based on this third set, in my opinion. He's played much, much better. That's a good one as well.
Missed it. Now just 2 points away from a place in the third round.
14.
Yeah. Too many routine shots. That smash down the line has been tried. I don't know how many times. Actually, missed quite a few of them, and he's still trying it. Where's the cross-court smash? It's a good mix.
Well, the luck of the net court.
Is that coming over?
It came over.
Okay, that's, I couldn't see it.
Match point 15.
5 match points for Kashyap Parubali. And now 14 minutes of play. Missed it. Just got a little overexcited there, I suspect.
But I think he was looking and found the right chance. And he's been very successful exactly on that and smashing down the line. So I think it was a good choice.
Minh did awfully well to get himself out of trouble deep in that forehand corner.
Yeah, cross court.
You can hear plenty of support for the Indian player here in Wembley. Points have come and gone, but another 2 remain as far as Kashyap is concerned.
Yeah. That's 4.
He couldn't, could he? goodness. Oh, it's going wide.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
And that's in. Oh, that's going out.
Would you believe it? Five match points have been saved by T.M.Nguyen. It is 20 all. Well, desperation shots galore in that rally. Look at that backhand. I'm sure he needn't have played it. May have been going out. But there was no question of that one. Way long of the back line. And how on earth is this going to play on the mind of Kashyap? Five opportunities to close out the match. He's failed to convert.
Yep.
He's got to put that out of his mind. Refocus.
That's what he's standing there doing now.
Yeah. And as far as this man is concerned, he mustn't think the hard work is done.
No. You have this, I don't know, automatic, I don't know what you call it, but it just happens so many times. You are desperate to catch up, and when you catch up, have caught up, you slightly relax, and then you lose 22-20.
Yeah. Who's got the character? 20 all. Got a win by two clear points. Oh, my goodness. Oh, it's landed in. Well, six straight points from 15-20 down to 21-20 up.
So, now we're going to have fun. Oh.
Well.
I actually think it's a good call.
Clip the outside edge of the line.
That's what I mean. I think it's in.
I'd hate to be a line judge, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Having to make a decision about that. Well, what it means in reality is that this man, having saved five match points, now has a match point himself.
Yeah. And I think it's very, very cool of the umpire not getting tempted to overrule anything.
Yeah. Too close to call. You're only allowed to overrule if there's been a clear mistake. Mm. Well, drama, excitement.
Here it comes.
Unbelievable. Well, we always knew he was a fighter. T.M.Nguyen of Vietnam came back from the brink of defeat. From 15-20 down, seven straight points to close out the third and deciding game, 22-20. Remarkable performance.
22-20.
Well, the umpire just confirming the score. Well, you have to spare a thought for Kashyap Parupalli. He will have nightmares about this scenario, having had those five opportunities.
And by far the best play in a third set, all point takings, I think.
An hour and 21 minutes. Well, it was a fascinating encounter. Dramatic twists and turns. And it's always sad in a match like that that there has to be a loser. But that's the cruelty of sport. So what that means is that T.M.Nguyen is safely through to the third round.
Safely. And he
and he will meet either the number 10 seed Boonsak Phongsana of Thailand or Wong Chun Han of Malaysia.